Hi, I'm Bhavna Somaya, and here is my review for this week's film, The Accidental Prime Minister. A few years ago, when author Sanjay Baru released his memoirs of former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh in a book titled The Accidental Prime Minister, there was outrage from the opposition, but after a few court cases, nothing came out of the protests. Something similar happened with the film adapted from the book. There were a few court cases, but the censor board has cleared the film with a few cuts. For those who have read the book, the film is a faithful adaptation of it. For those who haven't, but have followed the headlines, the film is a recap of what happened during that time from an insider's perspective. What works about the film is the concept. This is the first time that the Prime Minister of our country is the subject of a feature film, and what makes it interesting is that the narrator was his former media advisor. The film touches upon all the controversies of that time: the sting operations, the 2G, the 3G scams, the UPA government's nuclear deal, Congress Party President Sonia Gandhi, and Dr. Manmohan Singh's public persona. In my opinion, what is more interesting than the political ongoing is the anatomy of a relationship between a celebrity, Dr. Manmohan Singh, essayed by Anupam Kher, and his media advisor, Sanjay Baru, played by Akshay Khanna. Their reasons of attraction, reasons cementing the foundation of trust, their areas of conflict, their collective challenges, and the sudden an unarticulate withdrawal of the celebrity from his confidant. It is a film about the pressures a prime minister goes through, about the pride of a journalist, about unequal relationships and unethical decisions, a story about the country, no doubt, but also a story about our conscience. While the camera most of the time focuses on the ministry chambers and what conspires within locked doors, one misses the outer and the real world of the writer, his family and his sounding boards. Akshay Khanna is forever globe-trotting, sipping champagne and smoking cigars, and one wonders if he ever nurses any self-doubt or ever feels even remotely vulnerable. The advisor is forever flamboyantly dressed, but the costume budget gets embarrassingly constrained when it comes to the women, both Suzanne Burnett, playing Sonia Gandhi, and Ahana Kumra, playing Priyanka Gandhi, attired in fabrics unworthy of their stature. The Prime Minister's chamber and the PMO office is overemphasized and looks like a palace. But when he addresses a press conference, the flower decorations on the dais is fake and plastic. What is missing in the film is some humor and pathos. There is lack of energy because everything unfolds on an even keel, but then that is politics. Everything simmers but never explodes. It is a superbly cast film where all the actors comfortably fit into the character's shoes. Special mention must be made of Vipin Sharma, who plays Sonia Gandhi's advisor Ahmed Patel, and Divya Sheth, who comfortably passes as Gurshuran Kaur. Akshay Khanna projects the author and the advisor with amazing conviction. He is arrogant, aloof, compassionate and controversial all at the same time. He makes a colorful narrator and often winks into the camera. Anupam Kher internalizes Dr. Manmohan Singh in not just his physical appearance, voice, walk and body language, but also his reflexes and expressions. The eyes reveal too little, but they say a lot. The last scene, when Akshay calls out to the Prime Minister and he stops to look back, stays with you for a long time. So must you watch The Accidental Prime Minister? If you're a political animal, most certainly. If not, let me warn you that the film is completely devoid of any entertainment. But it is a film about our Prime Minister, our country, so the choice is yours. I rate The Accidental Prime Minister with 3 stars. If you like my review, please like, share and subscribe. If you don't like it, you must definitely comment and share your thoughts with us.